My Lime. Brought to you by Polygrip, the modern cream denture adhesive that grips evenly, grips comfortably, grips firmly all day long. And now let's all play What's My Line? And now let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, our publisher, panelist, and president of Random House, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
I've given up my weekly joy of insulting John Daly to sit at this end tonight because I wanted to have the pleasure of introducing you the prettiest young candidate for a philosophy degree, doctor of philosophy degree in political science at Columbia University that's ever been at that college. Wish there'd been girls like that there when I was a journalism student back in the days of Bloomer Girls. And here she is, Miss Susan Oakland.
I have big eyes for the gentleman on my left. Irreverent, irascible, and irresistible. Henry Morgan.
I have a marvelous package for you. One little deal on my left. Charm, talent, beauty, money. Arlene Francis.
And now, perhaps the main reason for this program's longevity, the very charming and erudite John Charles Daly.
Good evening, all. Miss Oakland and Henry Morgan, good to see you. In the early spring, we had a good do together, if you
will
remember, which we've discussed before. And I've got a secret. And the secret that night was that Henry overslept. Remember?
Yes.
Fun, though, because he has the absolute equanimity, as you could describe it, in human beings. He came in a third of the way through the program, sat down and said, well, let's go. And we did the show. And it was good fun. It was good fun.
Nice to see you.
John, did you tell Henry that you always oversleep?
No, I didn't, sir.
I should have.
Oh, I figured if I got you over on that side of the panel, I'd get some relief, but no relief. Well, I want you all to enjoy yourselves because we've got some very interesting occupations, none of which I'm sure will give you any trouble whatsoever, but you'll find them at least amusing and interesting. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the program, but right now let's meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Evelyn Borden. Right, ma'am? Is it Miss or Mrs. Borden?
Mrs.
Mrs. Borden, where are you from?
I'm from La Jolla, California.
La Jolla, California. Yes. Oh, that's lovely country. Lovely. We were out there late spring. Very nice indeed. All right, Mrs. Borden, may I present our panel? And now, would you join me over here, please, ma'am? And we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Mrs. Borden is salaried and deals in a service. And I think that we should start things off with Bennett Cerf.
Mrs. Borden, I was in San Diego in February, helping Ted Geisel run a charity ball for the San Diego Public Hospital. Oh. Did you have anything whatever to do with that affair?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Miss Oakland.
Would you have anything to do with something else that Bennett or Henry might come to you for?
Yeah.
Would they come to you in an enclosed place? Do you work in a building of some kind?
No.
$2 and $8 to go, Mr. Morgan.
Men, I assume that men come to you for this thing you do.
Yeah, I do.
Why not?
Yes, I don't know why not, dear. We'll find out why not. Now, would we come to you out of doors?
Sometimes.
Yeah, actually, what I think is meant to be conveyed here, Henry, is that the service is performed not within a confined area, but in the great outdoors.
That's almost precisely the way I'd understood it.
Good.
Is this service of yours, ma'am, in any way athletic?
Yes.
Would it do Bennett any good to take advantage of this service that you provide?
When you say any good, in what term of reference do you mean any good?
I was wondering.
In the sense that
he get pleasure from it?
No, most things would do Bennett good, and I thought perhaps this would improve his health in some way.
If he were to take advantage of this specific service, that's $3 and $7 to go, Miss Francis.
Mrs. Bourne, do you wear something other than just ordinary street clothes for your job?
Yes.
Is it a costume that might be considered smaller than an average street dress?
Yes.
Is it in the bathing suit area?
Sometimes.
Do you have anything to do on or in water when you perform your service?
Yes.
Has it anything whatsoever to do with a sport of some kind?
This gets a little bit sticky. I think if you were to say yes there, it would mislead them. So
it'd
let's
be a
give
sticky
them
sport.
A no, yes. No. That's $4. I don't think it has a specific application to a specific sport, and therefore we take it out. $4 and $6 to go, Mr. Sir.
Well, Mrs. Boren, there's a wonderful school out in La Jolla where they do all kinds of exploration and undersea things and have all kinds of experiments. Have you got anything to do with experiments or studies concerned with the things that are found in the sea?
No.
That's $5 and $5 to go. Sue.
Mrs. Boren, besides the small apparel that you wear, the scanty apparel, which may or may not be a bathing suit, do you also wear something else?
Sometimes.
Some other kind of equipment that might be connected with something that you might be doing in the water?
Sometimes.
Would that contain something? Would that equipment contain something?
Sometimes.
Is it about the size of a watermelon? The equipment?
Yes. Well, I guess actually it could be. It depends pretty much on which one you have.
What kind of watermelon?
A long one. Would it be an aqua lung of some kind that you would be wearing?
Yes.
In other words, your service is performed under the water.
Yes.
Are you a deep sea diver of some kind? Or of any kind?
Well, I'm going to throw all the cards because I think you've done very well to get this far. Actually, Mrs. Boren is an underwater stunt girl.
Oh.
Does stunts for the movies. She'd doubled for the heroine in Thunderball and rode a loggerhead turkey, which weighed... loggerhead turtle weighed 300 pounds. Yes, Henry?
You said that people come to her, or men come to her for this service.
Right.
Now, what men don't come to her for...
Let me put it this way. Ivan Tor's film company is one of her principal employers, and Ivan Tor's, I would judge from the nomenclature used there, would be a male of the species.
Well, it's very misleading.
Very misleading.
Does that surprise you, Henry?
But more than that, Mrs. Bourne has ridden the so-called killer whale.
Yes.
But he was very charming when you were there.
He's up in the
Seattle Zoo,
yes.
Right?
Aquarium.
Seattle Aquarium. And this is a real killer whale, and she rode on the killer whale's back. Did he give you any trouble? Did you worry about it?
No, he didn't. He was most friendly.
You ride him side saddle?
Yes, I didn't.
No.
I just tried to get on him any old way.
But, of course, the wonderful thing is, you know, we could say, and say very properly, that Mrs. Bourne has been in Sea Hunt and the Aquanauts, and yet we never see her because she's doubling. She's a great and skillful person in the water and with all of the various denizens of the deep, and congratulations.
She's very pretty and should be seen.
Yes, she's darn pretty and she should be seen. And thanks for letting us show you to be seen. Testing for you in just a moment after this word. And now to meet our next challenger. Will you enter and sign in, please? Richard F. Gailey. Right, sir? All right. Mr. Gailey, where are you from?
Newtown, Connecticut.
Newtown, Connecticut.
That's right.
You have some colleagues in the house. Neighbors, I dare say. Nice to have you with us. Mr. Gailey, may I present the panel?
I do.
Now, will you join me over here, sir, and we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Mr. Gailey is salaried and deals in a product. And we'll begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Mr. Gailey, is it a product that I might use?
Yes.
If I used it, would I have it in my home?
Yes.
Is it a useful product?
I think so.
Is it a product that I might find in the kitchen?
It's possible.
If I was serving dinner or... You don't know how I serve dinner. Is it a product that might be in evidence?
It could be.
Is it solid rather than liquid?
Yes.
Is it cold rather than hot?
Yes.
When you say cold here, I'm assuming that you bracket in cold basic room temperature and your differentiation is hot.
Anything you say, John.
Good.
Is it, instead of it being used as a course during a meal, would it supplement? Would it be in some supplementary way that it is used?
If you were to use it as a dinner, at a dinner... I would say it would be supplementary, wouldn't you?
Yeah. You know.
Would you ever put it in a drink?
No. One down and nine to go, Mr. Cerf.
Mr. Gailey, may I assume that this product of yours never has been alive?
The product is not alive, you're right.
Does the product ever come anywhere near a person's mouth or nose?
This gets into a very sticky area. I can think of circumstances which would reasonably result in this product getting near the mouth or nose, but I would not want you to put too much weight upon the fact that the product does get near the mouth or nose.
Can you hold this product, Mr. Gailey, in your hand?
Yes.
Without too much effort?
Yes.
Right? Is it anything that is either eaten, smoked, or sniffed?
None of those.
No. That's two down and eight to go, Miss Oakley.
So that I'm safe in assuming that it would be more likely not found in the kitchen.
Yes, you're safe in assuming.
That it would be found in some other part of the house, even rather than in some dining area. It would be more likely to be found in a non-cuisinary environment. I like that.
I adore it.
I just made up the word, too. would it be more likely to be found in a in a sociable part of the abode, in a living room or where people congregated? rather than in a bedroom.
Mm-hmm.
Is it used by more than one person at a time?
Well, I would say that the capacity to enjoy it is certainly there and viable for more than one person at a time, wouldn't you say?
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Is it something that is, when it's held in the hand, is it used as an implement?
You mean...
Can you do something with
no.
it?
No,
no.
No, that's three down and seven to go, Mr. Morgan.
I think I'd be safest in washing out most everything that's gone so far, right? Is this a product in any way entertaining?
Yes.
Would it help me to try to find out what it's made of?
It would give you some help, Henry, but I wouldn't say it would necessarily point you in a direction. And when we agree that it has some element of entertainment, I would again say that it has, in its general makeup, in association with other things, the capacity and the ability to give pleasure, and that's what we meant by entertainment.
You see, Sue, you ask a civil question, you get a civil answer.
Which you don't understand, but you get,
I forget the question, John.
There are English subtitles under there.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Now, this is a very general question. Is it in any way something like silly putty, something like that?
No. I don't think we can give it... No.
Okay.
No. Sorry. Four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
Does it have anything whatsoever to do with communications?
No. Five down and five to go, Mr. Cerf. Going to give you one more minute.
Mr. Gailey, might this be described as a game or toy?
No.
Six down and four to go, Miss Sue.
Help. Is it something that is filled with something?
In a manner of speaking, it's full. Yes.
Would it help me to know what it's filled with?
Yep.
Yes.
Is it then a container?
Yes.
Yeah. Is it filled with a gas of some kind?
No.
Sorry. No gas. Seven down and three to go, Mr. Morgan.
Is it filled with any kind of liquid?
No.
Eight down and two to go, Miss Francis.
Is it filled with... Is it filled with anything that you wouldn't want?
We have one more whack on.
All right, you can have a whack, Bennett.
It's filled with something.
Yes.
Is what it's filled with edible or drinkable?
I won't answer that question, and don't you. Now, actually, Bennett, you're getting close, but, you know, close like Kansas City is close to New York, because what Mr. Gailey does really is sell bird cages. With the Andrew B. Hendricks Company in New Haven, right?
That's right. Right.
And, wonder, you know, this is...
Why is
it... What's the trouble, Arlene?
Why is it a supplement to dinner?
I had this old friend who used to have a lot of plants at the end of the dining room and bird cages.
Oh, that's true. Yeah, something. I see.
It helps you to enjoy the chicken you're
right.
eating, you know. That kind of thing.
This is like pheasant under glass, Arlene.
But you know, actually, the wonderful thing about this company, which I'm sure you know a great deal about, but about which we didn't know too much, the Andrew B. Hendricks, I mean, have been in existence since 1869. You've got, what, three more years to go, and you'll be 100 years old?
100 years old.
And they ship all over the world. Bird cages. You make them big enough to hold Bennett? to help Bennett. I'm sorry.
I think John and I have got some of the original birds.
They're on this program.
We'll meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, this... And now the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery challenger, for which the panel is always blindfolded. Blindfolds in place, panel?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Good. Will you enter mystery challenger and sign in, please? As you know, this time we have a different form of questioning. One question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise. And we'll begin things with Miss Oakland.
I know that you're a member of the lively arts, whoever you are. Might you be considered a comedian?
Yes.
Mr. Morgan?
Are you a currently employed comedian?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
I must say that when you came in, it sounded like a stampede. Yes! You are a stampede. No, is there more than one? Is there more than one person?
Yes.
Mr. Sir?
Are you a team? Do you appear as a team when you perform?
Yes.
Miss Oakland?
Are you both of the same sex?
Yes.
Mr. Morgan?
Are there more than two of you?
No.
One down and nine to go, Miss Francis.
There are two. Do you perform mostly in clubs as opposed to television?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Mr. Cerf.
Are you about to open in your first starring motion picture?
Yes.
Are you Alan and Rossi?
Yes.
It's a continuing process. I guess open already is the last of the secret agents. Yes. It's open, but they've just opened.
In fact, we're leaving now to start the second one.
Start the second one? What's that one going to be?
We don't know.
Well, tell them what the part you're going to play.
Why play an underwater turkey?
Hello there. Hello there. An underwater turkey.
Do you need any makeup?
No, natural. No makeup.
I'd like to know how you came in that you made so much noise. I thought there were about five people.
Well, we were climbing.
Well, I walked over and I touched your hair for luck.
Did you?
I wanted to see if you used the same thing that I used.
Marty was on.
I crawled under the floor and I walked over to Miss Oakland.
Steve was trying
and looked
to be
real close.
Dignified.
Did you do something to me that I don't know about?
No, you're safe. Well, I must say, I'm glad that, by golly, the other medium opened up for you two, because they're ebullient spirits, and the good Lord knows we need them these days.
Thank you.
Bless
you
both. Thank you. Funny.
Thanks very much for coming to see us. Congratulations, we'll all be back after this word. Sue Oakland and Henry Morgan, nice to have had you with us. Hope you had some fun.
Oh, I've never had more.
And good night, Mr. Bennett, sir.
Good night. Oh,
don't. Oh. No, we'll do it this way.
I'm sorry.
So, I hope you get a PhD and be a pride to call me.
Oh, thank you.
Good night.
And good night, Henry. It was a pleasure to sit next to you.
Good night, dear. I enjoyed it. Good night, Arlene.
Good night, Henry. Thank you. Good night, John.
And good night, and thanks for being with us on What's My Line. What's My Line is a CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Cotton. This is Johnny Olson speaking. Tonight's program was pre-recorded. Yeah.
And now, perhaps the main reason for this program's longevity, the very charming and erudite John Charles Daly.
Good evening, all. Miss Oakland and Henry Morgan, good to see you. In the early spring, we had a good do together, which you will remember.
Yes, you did.
Which we've discussed before. And I've got a secret. And the secret that night was that Henry overslept. Remember?
Yes.
It's fun, though, because he has the absolute equanimity, as you could describe it, in human beings. He came in a third of the way through the program, sat down and said, well, let's go. And we did the show. And it was good fun. It was good fun.
Nice John, thing. John, did you tell Henry that you always oversleep?
No, I didn't, sir.
Oh, I should have.
Oh, I figured if I got you over on that side of the panel, I'd get some relief, but no relief. Well, I want you all to enjoy yourselves because we've got some very interesting occupations, none of which I'm sure will give you any trouble whatsoever, but you'll find them at least amusing and interesting. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before my friends on the panel a little bit later in the program. But right now, let's meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Evelyn Borden. Right, ma'am? Is it Miss or Mrs. Borden?
Mrs.
Mrs. Borden, where are you from?
I'm from La Jolla, California.
La Jolla, California. Yeah. Oh, that's lovely country. Lovely. We were out there late spring. Very nice indeed. All right, Mrs. Borden, may I present our panel? And now, would you join me over here, please, ma'am? And we'll let...
A long one. Would it be an aqua lung of some kind that you would be wearing?
Yes.
In other words, your service is performed under the water.
Yes.
Are you a deep-sea diver of some kind? Or of any kind?
Well, I'm going to throw all the cards, because I think you've done very well to get this far. Actually, Mrs. Borden is an underwater stunt girl.
Oh.
Does stunts for the movies. She'd doubled for the heroine in Thunderball and rode a loggerhead turkey, which weighed... loggerhead turtle weighed 300 pounds. Yes, Henry?
You said that people come to her, or men come to her for this service.
Right.
Now, what men don't come to her for...
Let me put it this way.
James
Ivan Tor's film company is one of her principal employers, and Ivan Tor's, I would judge from the nomenclature used there, would be a male of the species.
Well, it's very misleading.
Very misleading.
Does that surprise you, Henry?
But more than that, Mrs. Borden has ridden the so-called killer whale.
Yes.
But he was very charming when you were with him. The
oh,
one, he's up in the, he's up in the Seattle Zoo,
yes.
Right?
Aquarium.
Seattle Aquarium. And this is a real killer whale, and she rode on the killer whale's back. Did he give you any trouble? Did you worry about it?
No, he didn't. He was most friendly.
You ride him side saddle?
Yes. No, I didn't.
No.
So I just tried to get on him any old way.
But, of course, the wonderful thing is, you know, we could say, and say very properly, that Mrs. Borden has been in Sea Hunt and the Aquanauts, and yet we never see her because she's doubling. She's a great and skillful person in the water and with... all of the various denizens of the deep, and congratulations.
She's very pretty, and
she
should be seen.
Yes, she's darn pretty, and she should be seen. And thanks, Gordon.
Brought to you by Polygrip, the modern cream denture adhesive that grips evenly, grips comfortably, grips firmly all day long. And now let's all play What's My Line? And now let's meet our What's My Line panel? First, our publisher, panelist, and president of Random House, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
I've given up my weekly joy of insulting John Daly to sit at this end tonight because I wanted to have the pleasure of introducing you the prettiest young candidate for a philosophy degree, doctor of philosophy degree in political science at Columbia University that's ever been at that college. Wish there'd been girls like that there when I was a journalism student back in the days of Bloomer Girls. And here she is, Miss Susan Oakland.
I have big eyes for the gentleman on my left. Irreverent, irascible, and irresistible. Henry Morgan.
I have a marvelous package for you. One little deal on my left. Charm, talent, beauty, money. Arlene Francis. Good, and I thought... Perhaps this would improve his health in some way.
If he were to take advantage of this specific service. That's three down and seven to go, Miss Francis.
Mrs. Bourne, do you wear something other than just ordinary street clothes for your job?
Yes.
Is it a costume that might be considered smaller than an average street dress?
Yes.
Is it in the bathing suit area?
Sometimes.
Do you have anything to do on or in water when you perform your service?
Yes.
Has it anything whatsoever to do with a sport of some kind?
This gets a little bit sticky. I think if you were to say yes there, it would mislead them. So
it'd
let's
be a
give
sticky
them
sport.
A no, yes. No. That's four down. I don't think it has a specific application to a specific sport, and therefore we take it out. Four down and six to go, Mr. Cerf.
Well, Mrs. Bourne, there's a wonderful school out of La Jolla where they do all kinds of exploration and undersea things and have all kinds of experiments. Have you got anything to do with experiments or studies concerned with the things that are found in the sea?
No.
That's five down and five to go. Sue.
Mrs. Bourne, besides the small apparel that you wear, the scanty apparel, which may or may not be a bathing suit, do you also wear something else?
Sometimes.
Some other kind of equipment that might be connected with something that you might be doing in the water?
Sometimes.
Would that contain something? Would that equipment contain something?
Sometimes.
Is it about the size of a watermelon? The equipment, that is.
The equipment? Yeah. Well, I guess, actually, it could be. It depends pretty much on which one you have.
What kind of watermelon?
Yeah, what kind of watermelon? The audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Mrs. Boren is salaried and deals in a service, and I think that we should start things off with Bennett Cerf.
Mrs. Boren, I was in San Diego in February helping Ted Geisel run a charity ball for the San Diego Public Hospital. Oh. Did you have anything whatever to do with that affair?
No.
That's one down and nine to go, Miss Oakland.
Would you have anything to do with something else that Bennett Henry might come to you for?
Yes.
Would they come to you in an enclosed place? Do you work in a building of some kind?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Mr. Morgan.
Men, I assume that men come to you for this thing you do.
Yeah,
I
do.
Why not?
Yes, I don't know why not, dear. We'll find out why not. Now, would we come to you out of doors?
Sometimes.
Yeah, actually, what I think is meant to be conveyed here, Henry, is that the service is performed not within a confined area, but in the great outdoors.
That's almost precisely the way I'd understood it.
Good.
Is this service of yours, ma'am, in any way athletic?
Yes.
Would it do Bennett any good
to take advantage of this service that you provide?
When you say any good, in what term of reference do you mean any good?
I was wondering. In the sense that
would he get pleasure from it?
No, most things would do better.